Have you ever noticed this dipper-shaped group of seven stars in the night sky? Many of you have probably noticed this asterism, which is one of the most recognizable patterns in the sky. Did you know that this pattern of stars is a guide to help you find the North Pole star and many other wonders in the sky? In this video, we will first explore the constellation of the Great Bear. Then we will use the companion stars in this constellation to find the pole star Polaris. This will help us find the other stars that make up the constellation of the Little Bear. In the rest of the video, we will examine the majestic galaxies in the depths of these constellations and their mythological and historical backgrounds. Whether you are a beginner stargazer or a professional, there is something new to learn from this video. Let's dive deep into the starry night sky and discover the secrets of these legendary constellations. The Big Dipper is one of the most recognizable asterisms in the sky, but it is not a constellation. This asterism is part of the constellation Ursa Major, the Great Bear. It can be observed throughout the year in the Northern Hemisphere and never sets. It is especially easy to observe in spring and summer as it is high in the sky. Even if you don't know where the north direction is, when you scan the night sky at night, you can easily recognize the scoop shape formed by seven bright stars. But remember that the constellation Great Bear is in different positions at different hours of the night. It is also in different positions at the same hour of different months. Each of these seven stars has a special name. The two stars forming the tip of the Dipper are Dubhe and Merak. The other two stars that connect the Dipper to the handle are Fecta and Migres, the dimmest stars of the Dipper. The stars from the point where the handle is attached to the Dipper to the end of the handle are Alioth, Mizar, and Alcade respectively. The star Mizar in the center of the handle is very interesting because it has a companion star, Alcor, right next to it. During the Middle Ages, Islamic astronomers used this binary star as a test for the eyesight. You too can tell if your eyesight is good by trying to distinguish the star Alcor next to the star Mizar. Now let's turn to the two bright stars at the front of the Dipper, Dubhe and Merak. If you follow in the direction of these two stars for five times the distance between them, you will find the North Pole star Polaris. Since Polaris is close to the axis of rotation of our Earth, it always points north and never sets. This feature has made Polaris an indispensable tool for navigation throughout history. Now that we have found Polaris, let's move on to our next stop, Ursa Minor, the Little Bear. The Little Dipper is an asterism with a pole star at the tip of the handle. The Little Dipper is very similar in shape to the Big Dipper, but in the opposite direction to the Big Dipper. The Little and Big Dippers seem to orbit the pole star all night long, as if they are filling and emptying each other through their scoop. The Little Dipper is actually an asterism, part of the constellation Little Bear. The stars here are very faint and difficult to see because of city lights. If you are lucky enough to observe in a dark area, you can find Polaris at the tip of the handle of the Little Dipper, and then find the rest of the stars in the constellation. There are two stars forming the outer edge of the Little Dipper, just like in the Big Dipper. These stars are called Kochab and Firkad. They are also called the guardians of the pole because they constantly revolve around the pole star. The other stars are quite faint, but if you look carefully, you will see that they form a dipper shape. Polaris is undoubtedly the most valuable star in the Northern Hemisphere. It is very valuable not because it is close, big, or bright, but because it has guided people in finding directions throughout history, because it constantly points in the north direction. Sailors and explorers followed this star for centuries until the discovery of the Southern Hemisphere and the invention of the compass. A surprising fact about Polaris is that although it appears to be a single star, it is actually a triple star system, but its companions are too faint to be distinguished with ordinary telescopes. Now that we have found the Great Bear, Little Bear, and Polaris, we can start exploring the distant realms of these constellations. You might think that the constellations of the Great Bear and Little Bear are just a bunch of stars, but did you know that these constellations also hide some magnificent celestial objects deep within them? In particular, the constellation Great Bear is home to some stunning galaxies. The most remarkable deep space objects in the constellation of the Great Bear are the Bode and Cigar galaxies. These galaxies, which are also included in the Messier catalog of celestial objects, are also called M81 and M82. While M81 is a classical spiral galaxy, M82 is a starburst-type galaxy in which a large number of new stars are rapidly forming. In addition to these two galaxies, in the constellation Great Bear, there is a magnificent galaxy called Pinwheel Galaxy, larger than our galaxy Milky Way. Also called M101, this galaxy in the Messier catalog is a spiral galaxy and is 21 million light years away from us. If you have the chance to observe it with a telescope, the stunning spiral arms of this galaxy will immediately attract your attention. Ursa Minor, the constellation Little Bear, is a bit dimmer in terms of deep space objects than the Great Bear. Although there are not many bright deep space objects, there are a few hidden gems for professional observers. NGC 3172, also known as the Polarissima Borealis Galaxy, is a faint galaxy in the vicinity of the North Pole star and is a great target for astrophotographers looking for a challenging target. Next time you plan to observe, be sure to take your binoculars or telescopes and explore these spectacular deep space celestial bodies. These constellations are not just about the stars and galaxies they contain. They also have mythological stories and rich histories. Let's take a look at the historical origins of the Great Bear and Little Bear and their legendary mythological stories. Throughout history, people have grouped the stars while watching the night sky and associated them with the characters in their myths and beliefs and wrote stories about these characters. Today we call these grouped stars constellations. The constellations of the Great Bear and the Little Bear are interpreted in different ways in some of the mythologies of different cultures. In ancient Greek mythology, the Great Bear and Little Bear are linked to the tragic story of the nymph Callisto and her son Arcas. Callisto was a water nymph and a follower of Artemis, the goddess of nature, forests, wild animals, and the moon. She was also the protector of virginity and young girls. One day, Callisto attracted the attention of Zeus. Zeus seduced Callisto and slept with her. According to some sources, Zeus transformed himself into Artemis, deceived Callisto, and had sex with her. Callisto has eventually been found to be pregnant and expelled from Artemis' group and had a son named Arcas. Zeus' wife Hera, who learned about this situation, got angry and turned Callisto into a bear. One day, Callisto's son Arcas goes on a bear hunt and cannot recognize his mother Callisto, who is a bear. When he almost kills his mother, Zeus does not allow this situation and takes Callisto to the sky. He transforms her son into a little bear and puts him in the sky next to his mother Callisto, the great bear. Hera, who wants to make sure that they never sink below the horizon, asks Poseidon to keep them above the horizon forever. This is why the constellations of the Great Bear and the Little Bear are circumpolar constellations that never set. These star patterns have been shaped by different cultures and beliefs throughout history and have guided many explorers on their journeys. The next time you watch the fascinating constellations in the sky, remember that you are not just seeing stars, they have been guiding people for centuries and are part of history and mythology. The Great Bear, Little Bear, and Polaris, and the stories hidden in the stars. There are many things you can find in these constellations, from distant galaxies to mythological stories from the past and stars that guide you. We have come to the end of this first video where we started to explore the night sky constellations, their historical background, and mythological stories. In our future videos, we will continue to share stargazing tips that will help you find other constellations. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like it, subscribe to the channel, and press the notification bell so you don't miss another stargazing adventure. Please share your questions, ideas, and favorite constellations in the comments. Until next time, keep exploring the starry skies.